federal government should defend the country from attack, defend our borders, and that should be the priority. You can't be a friend to Eastern Kentucky, or you can't be a friend of coal if you're a friend of Hillary Clinton.
How do we make Kentucky prosper more? How do we as a people prosper more? How does America prosper more? And to me, the message is pretty simple. Let's leave more money in Kentucky.
Government's grown so large that our debt is like an anvil. We're dragging this anvil along and it's slowing the economy down.
We have to understand it's not about bringing people down, it's about having an economy that grows enough to bring everybody up. But an economy that grows fast has to be unencumbered by high taxes.
So I think we have to end the government's war on Kentucky, the war on coal, and then I think we should go further than that and start talking about economic development by making this a tax aid.
The bottom line is we have to get back to what every family has to do, what every local government does, spend what comes in.
We're in a worldwide competition, and for us to continue to succeed, for you to succeed, we've got to understand that we need to be largely left alone.
Everywhere I go across Kentucky, Republicans, Democrats, Independents, they say, fix the roads, fix our schools, make our state better. And I'm with you. Let's quit sending it overseas. Let's spend it here at home.
I say send no money, send not one penny of our dollars to people who hate us and people who hate Christianity.
Most of the laws passed in our country are written by Congress. They're written by regulators. If you do not elect, you can't unelect. So this is a big problem.
We have set priorities to decide whether or not we have enough to pay other people's country bill, which is overseas. We can't afford to blow our own.
We need the message of smaller government, the Constitution, and liberty. I'm going to keep fighting for them, and I hope you will too. Thank you very much.